You're watching the home of the NBA Finals, America's sports leader, NBC.
Jordan, you've proven your greatness time and time again. Your legend will forever live in NBA history.
Your mission.
You decide to accept it. Divine gravity.
One more time.
Karl Malone. The mailman. You dethroned his airness as the league's MVP. Your mission. To live up to the award and dethrone the king as the reigning NBA champion.
Scottie Pippen.
Four NBA titles.
Your mission.
Five in 7 years.
John Stockton.
The NBA's steals and assist king.
Your mission.
An NBA title. The mission is before them. Who will choose to accept it?
NBA Showtime, the 1997 NBA Finals. Here's your host, Hannah Storm.
For the fifth time in 7 years, the NBA Finals are in Chicago. And for the first time ever, the NBA Finals include the Utah Jazz, coming off that incredible win Thursday night over Houston. We welcome you inside, where a crowd of over 24,000 eagerly awaits the start of the 1997 NBA Finals. Hi, everybody. Hannah Storm on our NBA Showtime perch high above the court, along with Julius Erving, Peter Vesey, and the czar, Mike Fratello. And these guys will be here with us throughout the evening. We'll hear from them shortly. But let's get right to the Jazz and the Bulls, game one of the NBA Finals. It's a matchup of the league's two best teams. Chicago won 69 during the regular season, Utah 64. But since the All-Star break, including the playoffs, the Jazz have had the best record in the NBA. To get things started, let's go to the guys who will call the finals, Marv Albert, Matt Gukas, and Bill Walton.
All right, thank you, Hannah. First off, the major question for the Chicago Bulls, the physical status of the strained foot of Scottie Pippen. Earlier, Jim Gray talked about it with Scottie.
Thank you very much, Marv. Scottie, your foot's been a problem. Will you play tonight, and how are you feeling?
I'm going to try to play tonight. I don't know how effective I can be out on the court, but I'm going to have to make some communication with the field throughout the game, basically see how I'm feeling.
Do you feel there's any risk attached at all in playing tonight, and maybe should you wait till Wednesday?
Well, as far as some risk in the long run, I mean, if I'm not able to go out and do what I need to do to be effective, then it may hurt us in the long run, but hopefully I don't re-injure it, and then it can be a positive for me.
Scotty, good luck.
Thanks.
All right, let's send it back outside now to Marv Albert.
All right, thank you, Jim. And Matt, the other critical question concerning the Bulls, how will they defend Karl Malone? I would think they'll open up with Dennis Rodman for the most part against the mailman.
And Marv, it's the most compelling matchup going into the finals. And these two bring something totally different to the table. Now, Karl Malone has the size and strength advantage to power right through Dennis Rodman. Plus, Malone's perimeter ability can pull Rodman away from the basket where he hates to be. But here's Dennis Rodman doing what he does best, and that's being relentless on the offensive board. But you know, Dennis Rodman will use every trick in his book to disrupt and distract Karl Malone.
All right, and Bill, for the Utah Jazz, it is their first ever visit to the NBA Finals for Chicago. It's five times in the last 7 years. But you look at Utah, they seem to have all the elements to be able to compete on an even level with a club like Chicago.
Mauro, this is a beautifully complete and healthy Utah team playing at the top of their game. It all starts in the low post, where Karl Malone delivers early and often. The first quarter, he generally shoots a lot. That draws the defenders in. That enables his teammates to move and cut off relentlessly. They're often wide open. Karl's the best low post passer in the game. The rebound story for the Utah Jazz: when they dominate the boards, they're undefeated in the playoffs. But for the Chicago Bulls, since Dennis Rodman has returned to physical health, they have manhandled all their opponents. Now, the supporting cast for Stockton and Malone, Jeff Hornacek and Brian Russell, they've got to continue to put up big numbers and bring a dynamic presence. Now, since the dawn of spring, the Utah Jazz have been the best basketball team in the NBA. They're ready, and there's no excuses from Utah.
All right, so coming up about 35 minutes from now, game one of this best of seven NBA final series. Hannah?
Thanks, Marvin. As you've outlined so well, these finals match the two best players in the NBA this season, Karl Malone, the league's MVP, and Michael Jordan, who finished a very close second in the MVP voting. Ahmad Rashad spoke with Jordan about facing Malone in the finals.
Because of the opinions of others, they choose to give it to a guy who's been in the league just as long as I have and been just as consistent and been on a team that's just as successful this year. I can't gripe with that. You know, I can't have any jealousy or animosity towards Carl. Even though I may have had a good season, it certainly from a stat standpoint, it wasn't my best season, you know. But as long as I'm consistently thought of as an MVP, I'm happy with that.
Is there a scenario where it's kind of, you look at it like, well, you know, now we can go head to head.
Sure.
And see who really is MVP.
I'm the ultimate competitor. Yeah, I add that to the challenge that that I'm presenting to myself just by being in the finals. You know, there's other challenges outside that. You know, I haven't been to a final and we hadn't won. But sure, I have an individual challenge that, you know, yeah, Carl, you won MVP this year. Well, this is the MVP of the finals. You know, this is, you know, winning the championship. This is a leader of your team to the ultimate goal.
Karl Malone's already wrapped up regular season MVP, finals MVP, up for grabs. Jordan's won it four times. What does he have to do, Doc, to win it a fifth?
Well, you know, Michael, he's thinking forward. And the thing that Michael Jordan has to do to be MVP in this series, he has to elevate the Chicago Bulls back to a level that we've seen them in the past. He has to concentrate on making the other guys better and still get his own. And with Scottie Pippen being less than 100%, it gives Michael an additional burden. So I think this will be the greatest challenge of his basketball career, winning this series and being most valuable player.
And Michael might like the idea of guarding the mailman, but that assignment belongs to Rodman. But look for Brian Williams to have an enlarged role here, because Phil Jackson remembers in the 1994 seven-game series, Nuggets versus Jazz, Williams' energy was very, very effective against Karl Malone. And also, there are residual effects here, residual rewards for this whole thing. Sean Kemp, as you recall, Luke Longley had to guard him last year. Now he just has to guard the centers, and he'll stay out of foul trouble.
You know, Karl Malone is easy for you to say. had a career year in so many areas, but Malone's perhaps most valuable play came on a simple screen.
Hannah, sometimes it's the small, subtle things that great players do that decide wins and losses. Let's look back at the last play of the game between the Rockets and the Jazz. At the end of the game, ball out on the side. The Jazz have used the straight line play for years. Karl Malone in the second spot, John Stockton in the last spot. They normally like to curl Stockton around looking for that late pass leading directly to the basket. Clyde Drexler knew what they were going to do, but he decides to shoot the gap and try and head off Stockton. Little did he realize that Karl Malone was going to set one of the best screens he's ever seen. Stockton would read the play and run a fade towards half court. The ball is delivered on time. The guy left in a tough spot is Charles Barkley. He realizes he has to switch out. Too late. Clear look at the basket. Bottom of the net. Jazz are in the final.
A defining moment for the Utah Jazz, and certainly one the Houston Rockets won't soon forget. We'll be back in Chicago in just a moment.
Coming up next, the Utah Jazz have finally made it to the NBA Finals. We'll chronicle their journey from perennial contenders to Western Conference champions. And later, we'll bring you Peter Vesey's conversation with Bulls head coach Phil Jackson. NBA Showtime continues from the NBA Finals right after these messages.
Nothing's tougher on a car than drag racing. As a result, nothing's tougher on motor oil either. The extreme stress and searing heat generated by their hard driving can break down an oil in no time. That's why John Force uses Castrol. the only leading 10W30 that provides maximum protection against both viscosity and thermal breakdown. Because some people have more important things to worry about than motor oil. Castrol GTX. Drive hard.
Michael Jordan on life.
Life is being judged every night on the highest court. It's standing up to competition and thirsting for more. Sometimes life is an easy layup. Unless, of course, you can dunk. Life is about winning. Life is about loss. Life is knowing the toughest competition you ever face is yourself. Life is a sport.
We were on vacation.
Oh, your sunglasses!
When we realized we were sitting on a gold mine.
Rubber sunglasses.
Too bad none of the stores saw it that way. So we looked into getting our own store.
How much?
Maybe we need a catalog.
How long? So, any more bright ideas?
Actually, yes.
I can see clearly now the rain is gone.
Our own website.
It's gonna be a ride.
Soon, we were open for business everywhere. And before we knew it, we were selling shade to everyone under the sun.
Open a storefront on the internet with the most powerful network in the world.
Dateline Monday. Dateline is now on Monday. America's most watched news magazine. Dateline NBC, now on Monday.
As a player for the Chicago Bulls between 1966 and 76, Jerry Sloan was as tough a defensive player as there was. Named to the NBA's all-defensive team six times. Sloan also coached the Chicago Bulls for three seasons, along with a great shooting forward Bob Love and Michael Jordan. He's one of three Bulls to have his jersey retired. Jerry Sloan played on some very good Bulls teams, but he never made it to the NBA Finals. He has also coached some very good Utah Jazz teams, but again, never an NBA finalist until now. The state of Utah is in a state of hysteria, and it started with the shot by John Stockton.
Still kind of on this cloud because it's over 16,000 people there. We're trying to get home. You get home, there's stickers and posters and everything all over your house. This is just a great, great feeling.
And there's 10 or 15,000 people at the airport at 3 o'clock in the morning, and they weren't about to go to sleep, you know? And their whole thing is, this is something they've waited for since the Utah Stars won. They've waited for the Jazz to win. And yeah, we've had our critics along the way, but the true dedicated Jazz fan still hung the banners, still wore the Jazz shirts, still did all of those things and let you know they was Jazz fans. And those people there are the people that my heart go out to.
It was just an incredible feeling to share it with that many people and see that kind of emotional outpouring and emotional coming together and seeing their enthusiasm and being out 3 to 5 hours. I think just really epitomized what I think the Jazz fan is.
Back to Corbin. Tough defense. Come on. Havu, NBA of 15.
The early years of the Jazz being here were different. When they first got here, I remember in 79, they put Pete Maravich on TV marketing the team, and here we are, come watch us, and never played him. They benched him and said, we're building for the future, and wound up trading him to Boston. So I was really mad at him. We've come a long way since those days.
I've been out here longer than probably anyone in the organization, because I was here in the ABA days from 1970, and so I think I know what these fans are all about. This is a community that you feel part of, their family. And I don't think you can get that anyplace else.
Live from Salt Lake City, home of the NBA Finals.
You're on 1320 KFAN. How are you today?
I'm just so excited. Go, Jazz, go.
I love the Jazz.
Oh, I couldn't believe it last night at the airport.
They're my type of people. You know, I like to get in there with them. They're hardworking individuals, and they give their all to everything they do. And then when it's game time for us, they're still giving their all because they want us to win. And they love us, and we love them back.
I do go grocery shopping for my wife every Saturday, and I leave myself exposed to all these people in the aisle. But I have to say that to see the energy now, the signs on the front lawn, the signs on the business marquees, it is very uplifting to me and very gratifying.
It's sort of amazing to me because we've had people, dedicated fans here, that stuck with us when we lost out in the first round and we had a 2-0 lead and lost. And those people came back and they bought tickets because they was waiting on this day as bad as we were. And now we're in the finals and we're not happy just going. You know, we're gonna go up and we're gonna be ready to play.
Jazz owner Larry Miller is a devout Mormon, and as such, because of his religious beliefs, he doesn't work on Sunday. That includes watching the Utah Jazz play, either on television or in person. Larry Miller is not here today at the United Center. He has told us that he will be at home and may only sneak a few snippets off of the radio broadcast just to keep up with the score, but he will not even be watching this game on television. Now, basketball tradition goes back a long way in Utah, doesn't it, Pete?
I don't want to date myself, Hannah, but I covered that 71 championship in which the Stars beat the Kentucky Colonels 4-3. Zelmo Beatty, Willie Wise, Bill Sharman. Where have those guys gone? Great city, great fans. But it should be no surprise that the Jazz are where they are today. This is not the 69 Mets we're talking about. In the last six years, they made the Western Conference Championship. And we talk about Karl Malone and John Stockton. Of course, they're critical. But as far as I'm concerned, if Greg Ostertag and Brian Russell don't step it up along with the bench, they are not going to win this series.
Yeah, you look at the last four Western Conference champs that the Bulls have beaten on their way to the title, the Lakers, the Blazers, the Suns, the Sonics. Are the Jazz any different, Doc?
Hannah, they're different, yes, and with a different motivation. This is a team that's clearly out just to represent its community. These guys are a lunch pail team. You know, they come to work and there's no frills about them. I don't see any Jazz players going out and asking Michael Jordan for autographed sneakers as Gary Payton did last year.
Good point. Okay, now all the marquee players and the dream teamers here aside, Mike, what do you see as the key to the game? Can you isolate any other player?
I think a late season arrival in Chicago, Brian Williams showing up for the last month of the season, will be a big, big difference in this series. He's different than Luke Longley because of the number of things he can do. He's a player that's a little bit of small forward, a little bit of power forward, and a lot of center. The variety of things, let's look at the things that Brian Williams does to opposing teams. We think the center is starting down low, but he will step out, set pick and roll plays for the Chicago Bulls, but eventually get himself back into the paint area where we would expect a 6'11" center to be able to finish off plays in the paint close to the basket, and Williams certainly is capable of doing that. Then they will use him many times as a screener in the lane area to post up other people. But after screening, he finds the open pocket and turns into that medium range jump shooter. What does that do to the opposing center? It forces him to make a decision. Do I lay back and protect the basket or come out and defend that medium range jump shooter? We then see Brian Williams with the ability to step out away from the basket, and after knocking out that jumper, opposing centers must step out and play him one-on-one. The isolation has been created here by the Bulls. Mourning, in this case, comes out to play him after hitting the jumper. Brian Williams finishes it off with a little baby jump hook. Moving without the basketball at 6'11", starting on the opposite side of the floor, reading the screen by Kukoc, he runs a beautiful slice cut, puts it down one dribble, and is able to complete the play for the Chicago Bulls. This is a guy who is playing his best basketball right now because he's finally rounded in to the best shape of the season for him. Brian Williams, major factor.
And he actually had a chance to play for the Utah Jazz for $1 million this season. Well, he chose to play for the Bulls instead for roughly $30,000. Why? He's the only player on the Bulls team without a championship ring. Up next, Peter's conversation with Bulls head coach Phil Jackson. He's working on his fifth title, but will he be back next year? His thoughts on his future with the Bulls right after these messages.
Mike Proctor is a student at Buckley University.
and he's about to become the subject of a remarkable experiment. He will live inside this small chamber, cut off from all human contact. Alone.
Yo, get a little milk in here.
For the next 30 days.
Oh, no. Hey, I didn't sign on for this. Guys, I got tons of cereal.
I want some milk.
Fascinating.
Ready, please.
Got milk.
I have Mr. Patrick on the objective.
This is for Mr. Blanchard, who told me to make something of myself. For Miss Miller, who never let me settle for a C. For my parents, who believe in my dreams. For myself, for my future.
Be all that you can be.
In yet another torture test, we drained the oil from this car and added just this much Castrol Syntec. We then ran it over 100 miles per hour and waited and waited. You see, Syntec has a unique molecular structure that bonds to engine parts. And if a little Syntec can protect under these conditions, imagine what a full oil change can do. Castrol Syntec protects in ways other oils can't. And for your toughest cleaning tasks, try any Castrol Super Clean product.
Yeah, I'm a football guy, but I like the other contact sports too. Yes, nothing like the sound of a good hit. Now that's how the game was meant to be played. Only Pro Player has reversible home and away jackets, sweatshirts, and hats for pro teams and college. That guy should have been a linebacker. I've won 2 Super Bowls. I know a winner when I see one. Pro Player reversible jackets. Reverse it.
We're closing in on tip-off of Game 1 of the NBA Finals in Chicago between 4-time NBA champions, the Chicago Bulls, and the Utah Jazz, their first trip to the NBA Finals. There are plenty of stories in these finals, but the one generating the most discussion involves the futures of Phil Jackson and Michael Jordan with the Bulls. Will both return? Will just one come back? Or perhaps neither? There are no answers yet, but Phil Jackson did address the issue with Peter Vesey.
Phil, we know how much it costs to get a coach that hasn't won any NBA championships. How much is it going to cost to get a guy with 4 titles, 4 rings, maybe 5 by the time this is over?
Well, that's an interesting question, Pete. I don't know what it's going to cost, and I think peace of mind is really what it costs for me. It's not this organization, the Bulls organization, it's something that it can be trusted, that's got a backbone, that it stands for something.
So not only looking for money, money is certainly important to you, but you're looking for relationships?
You know, really, the money's the least of the worries. Everybody wants to be paid at whatever market price is. Maybe, you know, maybe Rick Pitino wants to set standards or Pat Riley wants to set standards. That's not going to do anything for you. You can't go out and enjoy life simply because you're the highest paid coach in the NBA or whatever. That you've won a battle because of that makes no sense at all.
If it's not money that's going to make your decision for you where you're going to go, what's the problem just in staying here? Is it something here where you might not feel that you have a chance to come back? Do they want you back?
Well, that's a good question, Pete. And I think it's a question everybody in Chicago is asking, because last year's negotiation was difficult and they got a forced in a corner, and some things happen in that negotiation that makes it tough to overcome some feelings that have lasted for a long period of time. The real reason and the real story is this. Does Michael Jordan want to play? And do they want him to play under the circumstances that creates a championship?
I don't have a contract, you know, so I haven't backed myself into nothing. You know, Phil is not here. It's quite easy. It's an easy choice. It's not a corner choice. You know, I'm not going to be here.
But what about the pressure on you to re-sign? What if you leave for whatever reason and you force Jordan to retire?
Well, I talked to Michael about not painting himself into a corner with this. But the reality is he has always said, do what you think is best for yourself. You know, I've done everything I can in basketball. But that's not really the way we want to see Michael go out of his career. Logic seems to say this is a man who's had a 13-year career in which he's dominated the sport for probably 10 of those 13 years. He should have every opportunity to go through the final chapter of his career the way he wants to do it.
Deep down inside,
want to finish my contract out and, you know, finish my season and career pretty much with Phil and with Michael and Dennis and, you know, all of us, you know, just continue to enjoy this until somebody is able to dethrone us.
Jordan said that he will retire if you're not coming back. He hasn't said that about Scotty. I think he's realistic to enough to understand that maybe you've got to get something for Scotty while the getting's good before he becomes a free agent next year.
Well, there's that, and there's maybe the fact that Scotty realistically is going to find happiness away from the Bulls in another form or fashion. But the reality is Michael needs Scotty's leadership. They work together hand in glove. And I think Michael would most decidedly feel about Scotty coming back. That would be an awful difficult job to finish out his career if Scotty wasn't here.
This crowd's going to bring it up. They're going to be loose. They're going to be freewheeling. They're going to have everything going for them. You've got to match that intense early on.
Are teams putting pressure on you to make a decision as quickly as possible, or have teams bailed out on you because you wouldn't make a decision?
Both. Both has happened. One, I couldn't make a decision. One, I said I wasn't going to, and people had to go other directions. And then there's some people that would like to, I think, sit and wait and listen at the end.
You didn't want to be Celtic coach?
I never talked to the Boston Celtics. That's one team I can unequivocally said I never talked. You know, that's one thing about the Celtics. They never liked Knicks, and the Knicks never liked them.
They've got an ex-Knick coach.
Who's the ex-Knick coach?
Rick Pitino.
He was never a Knickerbocker, though.
No.
No. That's why I was always surprised the Knicks hired Don Nelson. Why would they ever hire Don Nelson? He was a Celtic.
You've got an unprecedented clause in your contract that you are allowed to talk to these other teams. Is that good for the team? Is it good for the league to have such a thing, such a distraction during this time?
You know, it's a curiosity factor as to, well, how can a coach do a job when he's got to talk about another team? And that's distracting, and right away I realized that was distracting, and so I called an end to this type of talking because I need to focus on what's really important. What's really important is winning a championship and doing this job well.
Phil Jackson's team has taken the floor here in Chicago along with the Utah Jazz. Now, one of the job offers that has been on the table for Jackson is that as head coach of the Orlando Magic, Peter. What's the status with that?
Hannah, sources say that that no longer is an option for Phil Jackson. As we all know, a week ago, Chuck Daly turned down the Orlando Magic when they asked him to coach him. Well, in the last few days, he's reconsidered. And sources have confirmed that he's agreed to a three-year deal to coach the Magic for $5 million a year. As you recall, when the players had their players-only meeting back in Minnesota to get rid of Bob Hill, they targeted Chuck Daly. This is the guy they wanted. You also got to remember, this guy is going to be 67 years old on July 20th. But, of course, they measure those in Dick Clark years.
Okay, the players meeting to oust Brian Hill, and now it has resulted in Chuck Daly as the new head coach of the Magic. So where does all of this leave Phil Jackson?
Well, he's got a few options, Hannah. He's talking to the Warriors and the Grizzlies. I don't think he's going to take either job. The Grizzlies have whittled it down to Bob Hill or Gary St. Jean. They are the finalists. The Brian Hill, not Bob Hill, and Gary St. Jean, former Sacramento coach. So now his other two options are sabbatical for a year, which is definitely a reality, or coming back to the Bulls. I think that still is the place that he's going to go back here.
Okay, well, we are closing in on tip-off of Game 1 of the NBA Finals. The Chicago Bulls looking for title number 5. The Utah Jazz looking for number 1. We'll hand it over to Marv Albert, Matt Kukoc, and Bill Walton for the call. The NBA Finals continue on NBC right after these messages from your local station.
Episode in the summer? Yes! Wednesday's Men Behaving Badly is all new!
Great!
A sizzling all-new episode with an all-new Jamie? Nah, he's the same. It's the show that's all new! Right after News Radio NBC Wednesday.
The best things in life are free.
Pull into Texaco, and you could become a millionaire in Texaco's Race to Millions. Get a free game piece. You could win $1 million if one of the 11 Texaco drivers wins a race. Over $25 million in cash and prizes. One in four is a winner. So come in today.
It could be you.
Cinderella, just in yellow, went upstairs to kiss the fella. Made a mistake, kissed a snake. How many doctors did it take?
Get busy line answering from CallNote's voicemail service. You even get messages when someone is using the phone. Get the message. Get CallNotes.
Dodge Dakota is number one in horsepower. Number one in torque. Number one in towing, even number one in payload. In fact, Dodge Dakota is ranked number one in more categories versus any other compact. But that should come as no surprise for the truck that's full of surprises. Dodge Dakota starts as low as $12,335. See the friendly Dodge dealer near you.
Star Trek Deep Space Nine, tonight on NBC 41.
The Chicago Bulls have dominated the NBA in this decade. Familiar images evoke vivid memories of their four championships in a span of 6 years. In 1991, the Bulls showed they had some magic of their own and captured their first title. The following year, Michael Jordan's greatness surprised even him. In 1993, the Bulls became the first team to win three straight titles in nearly 30 years. And a year ago, Jordan led the Bulls to a record 72-win season and embraced another NBA title. Michael Jordan is now in the hunt for number five. The Utah Jazz have never played in the NBA Finals. In 12 years together, John Stockton and Karl Malone have won over 600 games, but never the big one. That changed on Thursday night when Stockton and Malone combined to write a storybook finish, bringing the elusive dream of an NBA Finals to reality. Now these two teams embark on a journey toward a goal that only one of them will reach. The NBA Finals begin tonight. Is the NBA on NBC. The 1997 NBA Finals. Tonight, it's Game One, the Utah Jazz versus the Chicago Bulls.
Go!
What time is it?
Game time! Move!
The quest has begun for the Chicago Bulls as they gun for their fifth championship the past 7 years. For the Utah Jazz, it is their first trip to the finals in the history of the franchise. And we welcome you. Hi, everybody. I'm Marv Albert, along with Matt Kukas and Bill Walton. This is a meeting of the two teams with the best records in the NBA during the course of the regular season. The Chicago Bulls ripping through with 69 wins, although they certainly have their ups and downs. And then come postseason, although, Matt, the record shows 11 wins and two defeats, they were not on track right throughout. They had some problems in the postseason.
Well, that's the amazing thing about this Chicago team. They still have not played their best basketball. But here are some factors why they can win their fifth NBA championship. It's not just the triangle offense, but their ability to score off opponents' mistakes. And then it's second shots, led by Dennis Rodman. They defend so well with their experience and quickness, and they have taken advantage on this home court over the last 2 years, winning 17 of 18. And let's not forget Michael Jordan. His shooting has been streaky lately, but he makes up for it defensively and on the board. And it's hard to go against Michael Jordan and home court advantage, but with a subpar Scottie Pippen, I think think Utah has an excellent chance to grab one of these first two games.
And Bill, for the Utah Jazz, it was a franchise record 64 victory season. They run through the playoffs in magnificent fashion. And here they are all set up. It's a genuine shot for Karl Malone and John Stockton.
Marv, a perfect season for Utah, but you don't get to this stage without absolutely an MVP player. And that has been Karl Malone throughout this season, start to finish. He is the game's best runner, the game's best shooter for the big man. He's the game's best passing big man. He's got the complete arsenal. He's their go-to guy. He will have the ball early, often, wherever, down low. And then there's John Stockton. He's a little man out in front, the quiet guy, but this guy is deceptively tough. He does it all. He's become much more of a scorer lately. He does, though, whatever is needed. The big thing for Utah is that they have to realize that their game, great as it is, that's enough. They don't have to do anything special. Just play the way Utah always plays. They'll be right there, Marv.
All right, so coming up, it is game one of the NBA Finals. The best of seven about to get underway when we come back in a moment. The always unique introduction of the starting lineups here in Chicago.
Hi, I'm Rebecca Romijn. Want to spend a few days with me at the next Sports Illustrated swimsuit shoot?
You could make a difference here. Because where I work, it's really hot. So if I get thirsty, you could get me something to drink. It's also really sandy. And maybe you could help me with my different swimsuits.
Nothing to do this fall? You could win a trip to the next Sports Illustrated swimsuit shoot. Apply where you buy Miller Lite.
These are the shoes that make athletes out of mere mortals. The shoes that make men fly. And these are the insoles that give them better cushioning and shock absorption. So replace your old insoles with Dr. Scholl's Sport Insoles. Make your shoes feel like new.
Today, you can be almost anywhere and buy almost anything without cash, without a check. Because today, there are credit cards, debit cards, and smart cards from MasterCard. The future of money.
What now?
You're using the wrong tool.
Ford F-Series with the world's only standard third door. And available new 5.4-liter Triton V8 for even more torque and horsepower.
Now you got all your holes dug, huh?
The new Ford F-Series. Built Ford tough.
The NBA on NBC is brought to you by Miller Lite, who reminds you that anything can happen at Miller time. By the Ford F-150. Strength after strength after strength. And by Gatorade Thirst Quencher. You don't have to live thirsty. Life is a sport. Drink it up.
A 58-degree cloudy day in the Windy City early evening in Chicago. And as always, we are joined by double coverage on the sideline. Ahmad Rashad and Jim Gray. Let's start with Ahmad.
All right, thanks, Marv. Now, Matt had mentioned in the open that the Chicago Bulls had not played their best basketball, and that is the center of concern for Michael Jordan. He told me that they have been very inconsistent offensively. He said they have made it through the playoffs to this point, playing well in bits and spurts, but he realizes that is not what it's going to take to get them past this Utah team. Now, in terms of Scottie Pippen has a soft tissue injury on his left foot, and he says he's going to warm up and see how it feels, and it'll be a game-time decision whether or not he will start. All right, let's go down to Jim.
All right, thank you very much, Ahmad. Well, I spoke to Karl Malone, and he told his team that being here is not enough. They expect and want to very badly win the championship. He told his teammates, hey, guys, we cannot be in awe of the Bulls. We cannot stand around and watch the Michael Jordan show. If we do, we're going to get blown out. He went on to tell me that they must match the intensity and not get rattled here in the United Center. He also said that we're a lot like the Green Bay Packers, old-fashioned from a small town. We're just going to come out and earn this thing. And finally, he said, hey, everybody's talking about the Chicago Bulls, but they've got to pay attention to us. We've got some great players, and I like our chances. Marv?
All right, thank you, Jim. And we're now set for the introduction of the lineups. And let's join in with the magic tones of the voice of the public address here at the United Center, Ray Clay.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. The Chicago Bulls welcome the world's greatest fans to the United Center and the 1997 tonight, game one of the NBA Finals is between the Utah Jazz and your Chicago Bulls. Now, let's meet tonight's starting lineup. First for the visiting Utah Jazz, at one forward from Long Beach State, 6'7", Brian Russell. At the other forward, 6'9", from Louisiana Tech, Carl Malone. At center, 7'2", out of Kansas, Greg Osterton. At one guard, 6'1", from Gonzaga, John Stockton. And the other guard, from Iowa State, 6'4", Jeff Hornacek.
As you heard in the introduction of the lineup, Scottie Pippen, it was a question mark, is in the Chicago starting five, still feeling pain from the soft tissue injury in the bottom of his left foot, but he will give it a shot. Right now we have a special announcement. We'll rejoin the public address announcer, Ray Clay.
Ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention to center court. To have with us tonight one of the world's greatest living sports heroes and a national treasure. Please join us now in paying tribute to and welcoming the greatest heavyweight champion of all time, Mr. Muhammad Ali.
The chant from this capacity crowd for Muhammad Ali is reminiscent of his emotional appearance at the Atlanta Olympic Games this past summer. You know, guys, maybe just maybe the only athlete in the world more famous, better known than Michael Jordan is that man, Muhammad Ali.
And Michael Jordan, Marv, spent time with Muhammad Ali for the first time in their lives. They got together behind the scenes in one of the locker rooms. There was a very moving moment today for Michael and Muhammad.
So we saw Muhammad Ali at the gold medal game in Atlanta in this summer's Olympics, and you got the feeling that every player was looking for a photo opportunity, wanting just to be next to him and shake his hand and be a part of that ceremony.
The officials, Bill Oakes, Dan Crawford, Ed T. Rush. Let's keep an eye on Michael Jordan. Will he shake hands with Carl Malone? You recall the last game of the series between Chicago and Miami. Yeah, there it is. All right. No question about it here. Little touch between Jordan and Malone. It was not the Alonzo Mourning treatment. Game one of this best of seven NBA final. Rick Ostertag and Luke Longley on the opening tip, and it's controlled by the Bulls. Scottie Pippen picked up by Brian Russell. And Michael Jordan being played by Jeff Hornacek goes to the post up and rebounded by Russell.
No surprise that they would go inside to Michael, and I think Utah can live with him taking the jump shots at least to start.
Beautiful pass. Yes, Karl Malone with the nice lead for John Stockton.
That's exactly the type of ball that Utah has to play, forcing the Bulls back underneath the basket. Great change of pace cut by Stockton.
And Longley had it knocked away. Russell with the save, and he called for the 22nd timeout.
I think that's a wasted timeout there by Utah. Too early to be calling timeout just for a single possession.
All right, earlier we talked with Michael Jordan on a number of subjects, one of which, will he use the extra motivation in Karl Malone winning the most valuable player, beating out Michael? Will that be used for this series?
I think that's something that Karl's earned. And, you know, people could easily said Michael Jordan's MVP this year, but they didn't. And to have animosity or any type of jealousy or use that individual accolade to motivate myself, I don't really want to. I think the motivation that I have is that, you know, we've been to the final four times in these four straight, we're in four out of three. This is the fifth time, we want to make it five out of five. That's where my motivation comes. It's not individualistic to where I'm trying to prove something about the MVP. And I love to win, even if I'm not MVP.
Karl Malone, very aggressive offensively. Michael Jordan, the gracious competitor, maybe the most gracious of our time. But that does sting a little bit. He had a chance, a realistic chance of catching Jabbar at six MVPs. On his Jordan. So the Jazz up by the score of 4-2.
So far, Utah has Michael taking the jump shot, fading away with John Stockton coming down to double.
Chicago's got Luke Longley guarding Karl Malone. That's going to keep Dennis Rodman out of foul trouble and allow him to sweep the defensive boards.
Yesterday, Karl Malone said he felt that he was borrowing the MVP trophy. He'd like to borrow one of the rings, one of those championship rings that is owned by Jordan. Jeff Hornacek, a Chicago area product being played by Michael Jordan. Malone now being taken by Longley. And here the early going. Phil Jackson is providing a number of looks on Karl Malone. The officials confront with each other. The outside official, Dan Crawford, said last touch by Utah.
Well, in many cases, it's going to be difficult for Dennis Rodman to get back in transition with Karl Malone because Karl runs the floor so hard, and Dennis goes to the offensive board.
And that a traveling violation.
Terrible start for Chicago. They look incredibly sluggish. Utah sharp. I think Karl Malone, when he gets Longley on him, can turn and face and get whatever he wants.
Well, in recent games, there have been very few periods of high-quality basketball played by the Chicago Bulls.
Not where I've been, out in the West.
A three-point shot is deflected to the crowd.
Of course, you have not seen Eastern basketball in a while, Bill.
We do have television out there, Mark.
I think Chicago would be very happy for Karl Malone to take Luke Longley away from the basket and just shoot jumpers and not get people in foul trouble.
And again, Jordan to the post up. Michael Jordan coming into tonight, 20 for his last 66 over the last two games, which is very poor shooting at 30%. And both clubs having their difficulties at the start. The Jazz with a 4-2 lead. Luke Longley comes off a strong game against Miami.
Well, I was just about to say, the reason both teams struggling, they're settling for jump shots. That time a little transition and a nice finish by Longley.
Oh, Stockton got the step. He took Hopper off the dribble.
And one of the rare times you'll see Michael Jordan make a defensive error on the weak side. Turned his back, never saw the ball.
Utah by two. We're just underway at the United Center in Chicago. Pippen passed on the three. And a three-second violation.
Well, the big men trying to get offensive rebounding positions on the shot they thought Scottie Pippen was going to take. Standing straight up is Ron Harper, and that's death against John Stockton. Too quick off the dribble. You're right, Bill. Michael Jordan looking the wrong way.
And very early, three turnovers committed by the Bulls.
What a pass.
Oh, Malone, he saw Hornacek cutting inside and was able to find him. The Jazz 8 and the Bulls 4. Pippen for 3. Rebound handled by Ostertag.
That was just a quick jumper by Scottie Pippen to see what it would feel like. Dennis Rodman didn't even cross midcourt on the play.
Great start for Utah. Just keep playing this game. Carl's got to catch that pass, though. I mean, that's a player like John Stockton, who is the quickest decision maker in basketball, and I think that includes Michael Jordan. He's going to put that money right, the ball right on the money.
So that's the first turnover committed by Utah. Timeout called. 7:25 to go.
The NBA Finals continue. Game 2, Wednesday at 9 Eastern, 6 Pacific on NBC.
Did you see the look on his face?
Hey, here comes another one.
Come to Papa.
Wait, not a Ford Contour. That thing's got more moves than a cat.
What do they think we are, Greyhounds?
Test drive the newly restyled Ford Contour. One drive will surprise you.
Hey. You guys up for a little Italian?
Now, get 1.9% APR financing for 48 months on Ford Contour.
I like cheese.
This is my quarter pounder with cheese.
There's cheese in there?
Two slices of melted cheese.
This is a classic.
Roll up your sleeve.
Don't mess with me when I'm eating Conor Burger.
And this is a my size meal.
My size.
Your size.
Any size. Right now, buy any size fry and any size drink, whatever size is right for you. And get one McDonald's quarter pounder with cheese for just 55 cents as part of a My Size meal. It's about giving people what they want.
This is my McDonald's.
I've missed more than 9,000 shots in my career. I've lost almost 300 games. 26 times I've been trusted to take the game-winning shot and missed. I've failed over and over and over again in my life. And that is why I succeed.
This is Dick, creator of Miller Lite Advertising. Dick knows many Americans work very hard, so he figured, why not do advertising sideways so you can look at it when you are resting? This is what he did.
Just the two of us.
Miller Lite. For those special moments when it's just the two of you. And no one else.
We can fly.
This commercial is made and approved by Dick.
Anytime the ball goes into the post to Karl Malone, Utah will either look to split or cut from the weak side. But Michael Jordan, for the second time, has his head turned, and Jeff Hornacek is going to take advantage with Michael Jordan not alert on the weak side. As Karl Malone now with two assists, and this is where he has really improved his game.
You always want to attack a great offensive scorer, but it's Karl Malone who runs the floor perfectly. Fights as a warrior in the low post, taking more jump shots lately. As a defender, he never goes up. He's always playing down low. The key against Karl is to try to keep him out of the middle and force him into that turnaround jumper.
And the Bulls have scored on only two of their first 9 possessions. Michael Jordan adding to that percentile, the Jazz 8 and the Bulls 6.
But in all 5 of their misses, the Jazz have got the defensive rebound, and that battle of the boards critical. Rodman, 0 rebounds on the evening.
Stockton with the lead for Ostertag, but he lost the grip. Phil Jackson wanted a traveling violation.
Ostertag has to tear the basket down there. This is the finals.
Now Jordan backing Hornacek. Went to the fadeaway.
Ostertag with the rebound.
Well, it's been exclusively Michael Jordan looking to score. Scottie Pippen is out there, but just floating, not really into the flow yet.
A team basketball again. Great block, Scottie Pippen.
Pippen with the recovery to stop Stockton. Here's Harper with room. And again, it's Ostertag.
Harper, Utah defensively is not double-teaming, even on Jordan. They've got the whole concept of team beats individual. It works against everybody else they play this year.
And Carl Malone able to keep it alive. Along with Ostertag and Russell up front. Hortison, Stockton in the backcourt. Longley got a piece of it. The block by Longley on Malone.
Quiet crowd here in Chicago.
Well, that's usually been the tone at the start. Foul on Hortisek.
One possession back when Scotty makes the great extension. Remember, he's dragging that leg a little bit. You see the grimace. This is the first exercise Scotty has had since the closeout game against Miami when he only played 7 minutes.
And the first foul committed by either team. 5:45 left in the first. Scottie Pippen. Scottie Pippen played only 7 minutes, game five against Miami here on Wednesday night. The injury called not serious, but very painful.
When you have that kind of injury, it's a little bit easier to play offense because you know where you're going. But on defense, when you have to react, that's when it'll sting you.
Here's Malone.
No box.
Russell. And he drew the foul. Karl Malone is now 1 of 6 from the field. Scottie Pippen is called on this foul.
Marv, you say not serious. That's because it's not on your foot. Scottie Pippen.
That is always a consideration, it should be pointed out.
Scottie Pippen able to deliver the jump hook, but you can see him standing, favoring one leg. Not a good sign long-term for Chicago in this series.
Well, what I thought was going to be such a big factor in this game, one, was for Chicago to come out just firing defensively as they did in the clincher against Miami last Wednesday, but with both Michael Jordan and Scottie Pippen falling asleep on defense as they had, it hasn't occurred yet.
Utah 10, Chicago 8. As we come up on 5 minutes to go in the first, Jordan lost it but got it back to Longley. And the Bulls very fortunate. Michael was able to deflect it back to Luke Longley. The game tied at 10. Utah's missed its last 6 shots. Longley trying to front Malone, who was able to beat him but not able to hit. Ostertag with the tip will not count.
Carl Malone has missed some easy shots. They can't get frustrated with that. That happened to him during the road games in the Western Conference. But Utah has been out great in front of every team, every game, with the exception of the Carl Malone 2-for-20 game. Utah very happy with this start.
Foul on Ostertag. Steve Kerr has come on, replacing Ron Hoffer. The game is tied at 10 with 4.5 to go. First quarter, the pass intended by Pippen. Intended to Pippen. And here's Hornacek getting it down. Russell for three. Rebounded by Malone. He's been off. 1 of 8 from the field for Karl Malone.
Mark, these two teams rarely play against each other. Just 2 times a year. Karl is offensive foul here. Whistled against the Bulls. But Karl Malone, he has to find out the defensive range of Luke Longley, Scottie Pippen, and Dennis Rodman. Here's Carl with a great offensive rebound. Not really sure if Longley can get off the ground. I'm not sure either.
Scottie Pippen was called for that foul, a second, and he'll take a seat. Tony Kukoc, who has struggled because of the leg injury, has checked in for the first time. And Howard Eisley, the 3-year man from Boston College, has come on. Foul is called on Ostertag, offensive foul. That is his second.
And Luke Longley hasn't had to get off the ground yet because Carl Malone is not making him work. I think he's got to step outside, face up, either take the jump shot if he has it, or beat Luke Longley off the dribble. And on the clock substitution by Utah, Jerry Sloan always taking John Stockton out on that first stoppage of play after 6 minutes. Phil Jackson taking advantage to get Steve Kerr into the ballgame to get a perimeter threat.
And both Phil Jackson and Jerry Sloan doing some shuffling. Judd Bushler has come on, as has Greg Foster for Utah, with just under 4 minutes remaining in this first quarter. As Rodman, who has been very offensive-minded the last couple of games. Utah's missed its last 9 shots, 4 of 18 from the field. Rodman now defending against Malone. Malone, yes, only his second field goal.
Probably one of the reasons why Phil Jackson wanted to keep Rodman off, has trouble defending in a post against a player like Malone. Dennis is almost better off playing a big guy like Shaquille O'Neal. He just does not play the power forwards that well.
Open shot for Kukoc. Kai Kukoc with a three-pointer. And the Bulls lead by 1.
Now, how important is that for Chicago with Scottie Pippen struggling? The Bulls are going to need an all-around game from Tony Kukoc.
Nicely gets it out to Malone. Rodman reaching for that rebound. That's his second board.
Nice denial of the outlet pass by Brian Russell, forcing Kukoc to walk it up.
And the basketball count whistle against Utah. And the foul is charged to Greg Foster. 2 minutes and 42 seconds to go in this first quarter. Look at Malone posting up on Rodman. And for Karl Malone, a rare bucket. He struggled, only 2 of 10 from the field in this first quarter.
Tony Kukoc comes right back with a very strong, long bomb to put the Chicago Bulls up early.
You're all-stars, performing all-star feats. They're the reason we make Ford Windstar with over 40 standard safety features. In fact, Windstar is the only minivan to earn 5 stars, the highest possible rating in government crash tests. A pretty spectacular feat in itself. Don't your all-stars deserve Ford Windstar? Created for the most important people in the world.
Michael Jordan on life. Life is being judged every night on the highest court. Standing up to competition and thirsting for more. Sometimes life is an easy layup. Unless, of course, you can dunk. Life is about winning. Life is about loss. Life is knowing the toughest competition you'll ever face is yourself. Life is a sport.
Go where you wanna go. Leave the boundaries far behind you.
Introducing the all-new Goodyear Eagle F1 with racing-inspired dual aqua channels that sweep water away for serious traction in the wet, especially in braking. The new ultra-high-performance Goodyear Eagle F1.
Serious freedom. Goodyear, Goodyear.
In good times and bad, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, for auto, for home, for life insurance. It's reassuring to know there's someone you can talk to, someone who knows life is full of surprises and can help you prepare for them. Being in good hands is the only place to be.
Jordan, Pippen, Malone, Danza. Only one will have a show on NBC this fall.
I think that's enough said.
Tony Danza, this fall on NBC.
Come on, Rashad, back in Chicago. Now, the big story going in this game was Scottie Pippen's left foot. He did play some in the first quarter, and then he has been on the bench. I just talked to him a moment ago. He said he's in extreme pain. He really can't push off on the left foot. I asked him, was he going to continue to play? He said he wants to, whether or not they'll let him play. Mark?
Artimani played the first 5 minutes, 1 of 2 from the field. His absence, obviously a major loss in many ways. He has been the Bulls' most valuable player of the postseason. Tony Kukoc from long range and kept alive as Bushler was able to tap it to Rodman.
And that's just the first second chance opportunity for Chicago, the best offensive rebounding team in the league.
Kick ball is indicated against Utah, so Bulls maintain possession. They get the new 24.
Scottie's foot is bothering him that much. He should not come back in. This series is going to go very long. They need him at full strength, not half or less.
Bulls lead 13-12 with 2:15 remaining in the first. Jordan, yes. Michael Jordan telling us earlier he would not force the issue, try to work out of the throes of a mini slump, but he said he'd let the game come to him. Well, he's attempted six shots. He's 3 of 6 from the field. Just under 2 minutes to go in this opening quarter. Here's Russell. Rebounded by Rodman. 3 Chicago players to the boards.
Wild shot by Brian Russell. He wanted it early against Jordan in the post. They waved him off. He was determined to shoot when he got it back.
Jordan. And Malone off the box out.
Marv, Utah is controlling their defensive board, something Seattle could not do last year. Gave them absolutely no chance to win the championship. That's going to be key. Who wins the battle of the boards?
And a strong move by Malone going straight down the lane for his third bucket. The Bulls lead by 1 with 1:10 left in the first.
And with Scottie Pippen's problems, Tony Kukoc becomes more and more problem as a, more important as a playmaker.
Judd Bisler, who has been a major contributor throughout the playoffs. Judd, a 7-year man from University of Arizona. His playing time has been spotted, but usually gives consistent minutes. Once again, it's Rodman on Malone. Malone is feeling for Rodman, and a foul is called. It's kind of a touch foul that was indicated.
I think it's going to be on Steve Kerr off the ball, who has a bit of a left-hand problem. He heard it on the play before at the defensive end. Howard Eisley, when he cut to the basket, kind of hung in the lane looking for a return pass from Malone, and Steve Kerr tried to push him out of there.
Real quick, Utah, 2-for-1 here, opportunity.
Eisley, Howard Eisley, who has done the job off the bench, usually comes on to spell John Stockton in his third year out of Boston College. Second round pick of Minnesota originally, and then on to San Antonio, the CBA in Utah.
And he's played marvelous basketball. He's got the toughest role in the entire NBA, backing up Stockton. One-on-one Jordan to close it out.
We're down to 10 seconds left in the first. The Bulls have a 1-point lead. Eisley trying to put moves on Kerr. Down to 2 seconds, and Eisley hits. What a shot by Howard Eisley. Bushler fires it up. Did well with a hand in his face to have that kind of power.
A flat performance by the Bulls. Very sharp by the Jazz. They need to shoot better, though.
So after 1, it's the Jazz 18 and the Bulls 17. Utah only 8 of 24. Chicago only 8 of 20. You're watching the NBA on NBC.
Nobody's tougher on motor oil than a police force. The extreme stress and searing heat generated by their hard driving can break down an oil in no time. That's why the Kansas City Police use Castrol GTX, the only leading 10W30 that provides maximum protection against both viscosity and thermal breakdown. Because some people have more important things to worry about. Castrol GTX. Drive hard. Also try Castrol Syntec Blend for added synthetic protection.
Give me Park Avenue.
The chores.
The stores.
Fresh air.
5.8% APR financing for 48 months on Ford Explorer.
You're watching the NBA Finals on NBC.
Karl Malone has brought his MVP game tonight. 11 shot attempts already. That's terrific. You see the numbers going down from in the paint. The team's forcing him to take those jumpers, but it's all come together early. The jumper in Rodman's face early on. And then when the defense collapses, Cutter's always on the move. Easy layup, burning the Bulls defense. And then a shot that Bill Russell couldn't even stop, much less Dennis Rodman. Shot chart for Karl Malone. Everything good in red, all on the left side of the court. A lot of easy misses on that right side. Unused to the Bulls' interior defense of Longley and Rodman.
Second quarter underway here in Chicago. Marv Albert, Matt Dukas, Bill Walton, along with Ahmad Rashad and Jim Gray. 1 point, Utah lead. Now Brian Williams on the floor for the first time. A beautiful pass again. Malone finding Foster.
Well, it appears that Carl has been hesitant when he's catching in the post, but what he is doing is expecting the double team when he puts the ball on the floor, and when they have, he's found the open man.
Randy Brown has come on for the first time. Here's Kukoc for three. Tony Kukoc with his second three-pointer. And Kukoc had been struggling right throughout the playoffs. In fact, against Miami, had a very poor series, only 6 of 27 from the floor. Brown off the steal. He has stocked it back. Goes to the pull-up. And hits. The Bulls lead by two.
Rodney Brown will be a critical factor in this series for the Bulls. The time he spends on Stockton. Stockton has not exerted himself offensively trying to draw a foul on the cut through right now.
Stockton. And here's Russell. Offensive foul. And a difficult start. Brian Russell. 0 for 4 from the field.
And Jerry Sloan unhappy with that call, thinking Tony Kukoc too far underneath the rim to take that charge on Brian Russell. So far, Kukoc giving it to the Bulls at the offensive end, and an unexpected nice play at the defensive end.
Shannon Anderson, the rookie from Georgia, has played so well. He's come on for the first time. That's a traveling violation on Brian Williams. Minute and a half gone by in the second quarter. And it's the Bulls 22 and the Jazz 20.
Bill Jackson looking out on the floor trying to figure out where the Jazz will go right now with Karl Malone getting a breather. John Stockton will be the man to decide what happens there.
Antoine Carr usually just steps right in and takes all the shots. They run the same plays for him, maybe not as many cross screens. He's not as good a passer, but an outstanding low post scorer, Antoine Carr.
Kukoc gets it back to Brown, and the rebound handled by Carr. Traveling violation. What a play by Hoffer. That caused the travel. Stockton had no room to operate. Timeout call. 2:03 gone by. We're in the second quarter. It's the Bulls by 2 points.
Voila.
Make communications work.
He
won the Kentucky Derby. He won the Preakness Stakes. And this year, as he heads into the final race of the Visa Triple Crown Challenge, there really seems to be an absolute 100% sure thing. If you try to use American Express at the Belmont Stakes, you won't get in, because the only card accepted at the gate is Visa. It's everywhere you want to be.
The NBA on NBC is brought to you by United Airlines, heading in a different direction. United Airlines, rising by Acura, the true definition of luxury. Yours, and by Mountain Dew, who reminds you to do the do.
Now there's the city of big shoulders, and a lot rides on the shoulders of Tony Kukoc. Anytime he hits that first three, usually a good sign for the Bulls. A good passer finding Booker, and then stepping up in the lane, taking that charge from Brian Russell. But the playoffs have been very nasty to Tony Kukoc. All right in the first couple of rounds, but really slumping tremendously against Miami, unable to find his shot.
But his foot is killing him. I was with Tony in the locker room before the game. He says it's just nothing but trouble. Can't run, can't push off. He's just trying to get through it so it'll get better for next season.
Yeah, he's been forcing it back with that strained right arch. Had problems with the foot all season. Tony Kukoc off the spin. Couldn't hit that one. 22-20, Bulls up with 9.5 remaining in this first half. Chris Morris on the floor for the first time. It's Foster. Good ball movement by the Jazz.
All of that set up by the deadly cross screen by John Stockton. And what you try to do defensively is bump him off so he can't get a good look. But Randy Brown bumped him right into the screen.
The Jazz's ball movement has been far superior, as has their rebounding. If they had any kind of touch on their jumpers, particularly Carl, they'd have a 10-point lead here.
Carl Malone is sitting down at the moment, 3 of 11 from the field. 6 points, 5 rebounds, 3 assists. Crowd won't travel, called on Stockton, but a foul committed. And it's against Chicago. It is on Brown.
Well, you can chat with a member of the Chicago Bulls. Join Bulls forward Jud Bushler in a live chat session tomorrow. It's Monday at 5 p.m. Eastern Time on NBA.com, the official website of the NBA. Jerry Sloan now has a backcourt of Stockton and the rookie Anderson. And he has Foster with Carr and Morris up front. Michael Jordan making his return. Michael Jordan. 3 of 8 from the field, 6 points. The Jazz up by 1, 23-22. And Chicago with Jordan and Brown at the guards, Pippen, Kukoc, and Williams on the front line. Now Jordan played by the rookie Anderson. Michael Jordan shooting over Brandon Anderson.
Utah clearly has made the decision not to double team. Jerry Sloan does not want everybody else getting layups. More importantly, keep off the offensive glass.
Foster feeling it. Rick Foster has the good touch. A guy who's made the rounds a couple of years at Washington, Atlanta, Milwaukee, Chicago, Minnesota, Utah.
He got his start at UCLA. That was the big
yes, he did. Randy Brown. Actually, you look at his record, it sounds like Matt Guthis is out there.
Stockton throwing himself in. They call the offensive foul that time.
And for Stockton, it is his first.
Well, Greg Foster has found a home here and has a role, much like Bill Wennington for the Chicago Bulls. John Stockton, so quick on that crossover, just runs Michael Jordan right out of there. A little extra acting on the part of Michael.
That's not a foul.
Here's Pippen. Pippen on the follow.
That's the way to dive on the floor.
Good hustle by Morris to guide it to Anderson. Utah by 1. It's game 1 of the best of 7 NBA Finals Series. Game 2 here in Chicago on Wednesday, right here on NBC, starting 9 o'clock Eastern time. Chris Morris never shy about firing from all angles, and looked like Foster and Kukoc and Anderson got involved.
Are you trying to say, Mark, that Chris Morris made up his mind what he was going to do as soon as he caught that ball? Although that play was kind of called for him, anything popping up off the weak side, and he is a three-point threat, but he didn't even see the basket when he let the ball.
Utah should come back to Greg Foster. He's the one with the hot hand.
That last foul was called on Anderson, and then again away from the ball, Brown went flying. Foster picks up his second. Timeout is being indicated. That's the second team foul committed by Utah. Chicago just won. The Jazz by one. We played 5 minutes of the second.
Throughout the ship.
Oh, man!
For Annie, there's no changing course.
She's sending us right into the island.
I am never leaving the house again.
No slowing down.
We're gonna crash!
And no getting off. Because on June 13th, Rush Hour hits the water. Speed 2, Cruise Control.
I just bought a condo here.
Rated PG-13. Rush Hour hits the water June 13th.
Well, not much of a crowd here today, but it should be a good game. All right, Stewart's batting three
here. Hold my Budweiser. I'm going to go find those guys.
All right, Wedman toes the rubber. Delivers.
Whoa! A long drive to left field. That ball's going to carry. It's going out of here. There's one lucky fan out there, but he's got something in his hands.
Something in
what's he going to do? He's got to make his move. It's nothing but good.
That ball bounced about 20 feet off his head.
Please, just let go of the beer.
Let go of the beer, son.
I've always been what you call a free spirit. Woo! I just love having a good time. And I guess that's how I play basketball, too.
She's one of the best point guards in the world.
Just ask my coach here in Germany.
Yeah, that's true.
I play basketball all over the world, and I go anywhere for a good game. Now I'm ready for my biggest challenge yet, the WNBA. See you in America.
Watch Michelle Timms and the Phoenix Mercury this summer.
Dateline Monday. Dateline is now on Monday. America's most watched news magazine, Dateline NBC, now on Monday.
Statline and Karl Malone and John Stockton in the early going. Well, guys, this is always a category that some outstanding players, whatever the sport, have a tough time dealing with. Even in the NBA, some refer to it as the Ernie Banks category. Great players who have not been able to win a title, and two of those players on the court today in the uniform of the Utah Jazz, and John Stockton and Karl Malone.
And one just eliminated, Charles Barkley, a very emotional scene in Houston Thursday night.
7:04 remaining in this first half. The Jazz by one. Let's check in with Jim Grimm. Jim?
All right. Thank you, Mark. During that timeout, Jerry Sloan very happy with the defensive effort of the Utah Jazz. He said, offensively, however, you must set and hold your screens and take much better shots. Unhappy with the shot selections. Mark?
All right, Jim, and a fine shot selection on the part of Michael Jordan, who had the tongue wagging and put the move on and split right through and was able to hit.
Going to work on rookie Shannon Anderson, but no help from Antoine Carr, who was supposed to step up and trap that pick and roll. Michael just too quick.
Anderson beaten on the play. Randy Brown was just called for a foul, and another foul against the Bulls. It's on Jordan, his first.
Speaking of trapping the pick and roll, Stockton caught along the baseline, and Jordan just came in and was karate chopping.
10 points for Jordan on 5 of 10 shooting. Randy Brown now defending on John Stockton. Here's Carr. Beautiful move by Antoine Carr, the 13-year professional from Wichita State. Original big dog for Milwaukee's Glenn Robinson. Look out, Brown hit the floor. Shake it up. Ryan Williams checking him over. Foul was called on Carr.
Now right out of the triangle offense, Brian Williams, only 9 regular season games, but has a feel for this play. When he gets in the post, who's ever in the corner will make that baseline cut. He found Randy Brown.
Well, let's take a listen to this. You'll see it full speed.
The thing that's been so impressive about this game so far, Mark, and what Marv, and what I think will hold up throughout this series, is that you got the two best passing teams in basketball today. In this era of individualism and athleticism, you got great teamwork on both sides.
First time that the Bulls have been at the free throw line. Here's Karl Malone making his return, replacing Rick Foster. Did a nice job. 3 of 3 from the field. 6 points for Foster, and Dennis Rodman will come on for Tony Kukoc, who contributed with 6 points.
And Bill, because they are the two best passing teams, they are the two highest scoring teams in the league at 103 a game. But this is ridiculous here so far in the first half. Both teams with 27 points, mainly because they're playing just half-court basketball. Nobody get anything going in transition.
Jazz, they don't turn it over. It's going to be difficult for Chicago to force Utah into mistakes.
Bulls have a 1-point lead. We're halfway through the first half. Morris strip. Stockton recovers. Shot clock running down. Here's Anderson for 3. And Carr able to get to it. Nice pass from Anderson. Anderson with the setup.
Utah playing the team game. Everything for Chicago, one-on-one off the dribble, particularly Jordan and Kukoc.
Jordan. Michael Jordan has 12, and the Bulls lead by 1.
Michael's eyes are wide as saucers right now, going against rookie Shannon Anderson.
Meanwhile, at the other end, Shannon Anderson enjoying himself.
The Bulls have not played a team like this in a long time.
Shannon Anderson, a second-round draft pick. Utah did not have a number one. Oh! The opening for Scottie Pippen. That's his second field goal. And the Bulls lead now 32-31. Shannon Anderson, during the regular season, provided a major lift. The brother of Willie Anderson spent time with the Miami Heat.
And the Utah Jazz have not played a team anything like the Chicago Bulls with their triangle offense, ball movement, and player movement, as Michael Jordan just rises up on Shannon Anderson. And then the little handoff, one hand, just a touch pass, as Scottie Pippen finishing, but falling, not falling, but coming down gingerly on that left foot.
Previous foul was called on Dennis Rodman. Now Bill Oakes over the scorer's table and indicating a technical foul on Chicago Bulls assistant coach Tex Winter. Apparently that triangle that was thrown by Tex in the wrong color.
It was an isosceles triangle, right, rather than an equilateral triangle.
Tex, a very quiet gentleman on the bench, but obviously, as we all know, you can't hit a nerve.
Well,
all times.
And it's probably not just the first time Tex has said something in this game. He's probably been pecking away.
Out of physical action.
Settle down, Utah. Play your game.
4.5 left in the second quarter. And a travel shot on Anderson.
Utah is attacking Michael Jordan. They've bought into Jerry Sloan's, look, don't get intimidated by this guy. He's going to do his thing. He's going to have a great game. But you got to come back and get your game going, too. The Jazz have established themselves.
7 turnovers committed by Utah, 7 by Chicago. Jordan with the open shot. And Carr reaching for that rebound. The game tied at 32.
Good stab defense by Scottie Pippen to slow down.
Shot clock at 7. Down to 3. Malone. Yes. Carl Malone has 10 points. It's the Jazz 34 and the Bulls 32.
It used to be. Oh, goodness gracious sakes alive.
That's almost a frustration shot because right now Dennis Rodman having problems guarding Carl Malone.
Carl feels it. They got a double team and get it out of his hand.
Last touch by Brown.
Dennis Rodman just does not close quick enough on Carl Malone. The shot clock is winding down. Carl knows he's going to have to put up a shot, but just by creating space there, gets far enough away from Dennis Rodman, who got a hand up, but way too late.
Stockton got the step. John Stockton with his fourth field goal. He has 8 points and 4 assists. The Jazz leading by 4 as we approach 3 minutes to go in the first half.
What a pass.
Rodman is fouled by Carr.
Again, the offensive rebounding and court savvy and presence of the Jazz giving him more shots. Stockton has been passing early. That freezes the defense. Not a great leaper. Not blazing speed, but great quickness. Depth change reception.
Dennis Rodman serving up the air ball. A reminder, on Wednesday, we hope you join us back here in Chicago, 9 o'clock Eastern Time, 6 o'clock Pacific. Game 2 of the NBA Finals. It's the Bulls and the Jazz. Game 2, Wednesday, 9 o'clock Eastern, right here on NBC.
Jazz killing Chicago on the boards, 23-14.
Air ball being played by Rodman. What we've seen here in the first half by Chicago, and those who have been watching the Bulls as of late, can't be surprised they have not been playing their best basketball during the playoffs, despite the record of 11-2 during the playoff run. Bad pass by Brian Williams, leading to another Chicago turnover. Rodman gambled, could not take advantage. Pippen with the rebound.
Carl didn't have good balance that time, but the Utah Jazz are overplaying every post-entry pass.
Again, the hesitation by Pippen that led to the turnover. Stockton for 3. John Stockton, the hero, the other night against the Houston Rockets, which put the Utah Jazz into the finals by virtue of his 3-pointer, just hit that open 3-point shot to extend to a 7-point Utah lead.
Chicago doesn't make many mistakes either, but a bad play by Scottie Pippen at the other end got Utah into their transition game, and John Stockton nailed it.
Challenge me. Doubt me. Disrespect me. Tell me I'm older. Tell me I'm slower. Tell me I can no longer fly. I want you to.
Thank you.
coming up at halftime, the Prudential Halftime Report. We'll take a closer look at Utah's John Stockton. Jim Gray was in Salt Lake City yesterday to talk with John. Hannah Storm, Julius Erving, Peter Vesey, and the czar of the telestrator, Mike Fratello, will provide analysis of the first half. And that's coming up on the Prudential Halftime Report just moments away.
Bench production for the Jazz on fire. Isley first of all, and then Craig Foster comes in. The jumper's going down. The shooting percentage skyrocketing for the Jazz here in the second quarter as Antoine Carr drills that jumper. 60% for the Jazz in the second after 33% to open it up tonight.
And Utah getting the help off the bench. 7-0 run by the Jazz. They lead up 39-32. Here's Jordan. Rodman with the tip. Rodman again. And took a poke in the eye.
Take advantage. Carl Malone quickly. Rodman is confused. Scotty helped him out.
Minute 35 remaining. First half. Marv Albert, Matt Dukas, Bill Walton, Bob Rashad, Jim Gray from the United Center. Game one of this best of seven NBA final series. Steve Kerr back on the floor. Scottie Pippen posting up. Michael Jordan being played by Brian Russell. Jordan receiving a number of looks here in the first half, and the foul is called on Anderson.
Well, the Bulls have been very quiet on the offensive glass so far in this first half, but Dennis Rodman volleyballing the ball to himself a couple of times, but Karl Malone coming in there at the end of the play, catching Dennis Rodman right in the eye.
I like the volleyball, you know, that's coming up in Chicago in 3 weeks here.
That was for you,
the
Bill.
Beach volleyball, yes.
And Pippen making his first appearance at the line. He has 5 points. Dennis still trying to shake things off.
Never fun to get an elbow to the face, particularly by a man big and strong as Karl Malone.
The Utah lead is now 3 with a minute 10 left in the first half. So the matchup is Kerr on Stockton. Hornacek is back, played by Jordan. Hornacek got the step. Rodman with the save. Dangerous save. But Longley was able to retrieve.
Marv, Hornacek's had a tough day of it. 1 for 3. Shandon Anderson was playing better. Jerry Sloan decided to come back with his main guy, though.
And Greg Ostertag is also back on the floor defending on Rodman. Jordan. Rodman. Terrific ball instincts, and he fires. Dennis a bit encouraged from recent development. On the loose ball, one of his great skills, and he's brought the Bulls within one.
The Jazz falling asleep, I think, dulled beyond belief when Dennis took that three-point shot.
Utah by one. We're down to 15 seconds and a half.
High scoring first down.
You're talking Eastern style. Russell for three. Just did beat the 24. And that is his first field goal. Final seconds of the half. Halftime here in Chicago. Game one of the NBA final series. Karl Malone, 5 of 14, 10 points, 6 rebounds. Michael Jordan, 6 for 14 for 12 points. It's the Jazz 42 and the Bulls 38. Hannah Storm of the Prudential Halftime Report in a moment.
The French Open continues on NBC Friday morning with the men's semifinals. Saturday at 3 p.m., the women's final, and Sunday at 9 a.m., the men's final, this weekend on NBC.
Jack, what are you guys doing here?
See the dude. Be the dude. Whoa. Nothing's more intense than slamming a dude.
Please stand by. This flight
Traffic will begin boarding momentarily.
Paging Mr. Wright. Paging Mr. Wright. Tube is oversold.
Last delay.
Would you like to speak to my supervisor?
This flight has been delayed. We have no further information.
If Orville and Wilbur had to go through what you do just to fly,
ladies and gentlemen,
they never would have gotten off the ground.
The flight to Kitty Hawk has been canceled.
Isn't it time an airline started heading in a different direction? United Airlines, rising.
It is said that good things come to those who wait. But in business, greater things come to those who refuse to. And for people like these, an incredible weapon has been created.
Velo from Philips Magnavox. Windows, email, internet. The power of a computer in the palm of your hand.
Sales, Joe! There's always a future in sales!
Just think, Joe! You're gonna be your own boss!
Joe! Plastics last forever!
Joe, let's not call it a pyramid scheme.
Emu, Joe. It's the pork of the future.
Lots of career opportunities. One car, make it a good one. The Civic Sedan from Honda.
Joe, 12 men, one boat. What could be better?
At the age of 21, he is rewriting golf history. After his amazing win at the Masters, Tiger Woods goes for his 7th USGA championship in 7 years. Tiger's incredible march continues as he vies for back-to-back Grand Slam victories in his first appearance as a pro at the US Open, coming June 12th to NBC.
This is the Prudential Halftime Report, brought to you by Prudential. Bringing strength and stability to America's families through insurance, healthcare, real estate, and financial services.
Halftime of Game 1 in Chicago with the Jazz leading the Bulls 42-38. John Stockton with 11 points and 4 assists. Karl Malone with 10 points and 6 rebounds. Michael Jordan leading the Bulls with 12 points. Hi, everybody. Hannah Storm along with Julius Erving, Peter Vesey, Mike Fratello. We'll discuss the first half in just a few moments. But first, the guy with the choir boy looks but the nerves of steel, Utah's John Stockton. Interestingly, there are parallels between Stockton and Michael Jordan. Each of them came into the NBA in 1984. Both of them are two-time Olympians. And each is among the 50 greatest players in NBA history. But whereas Jordan has 4 championship rings, Stockton is playing in his first finals. Stockton spoke with Jim Gray.
The time, 18. Shot, Jordan, it's over!
The Utah Jazz select John Stockton of Gonzaga University.
When you went to college and you went through Gonzaga, what was your ultimate goal? What were you thinking? Everybody had thoughts for you, but what were you trying to obtain?
Really nothing. I never had hopes of even going really to the next level at any stage. As a sixth grader, I wanted to make the varsity someday. Hopefully, if the opportunity arose, I'd hope to make the varsity in high school someday. I had no idea a scholarship would ever come or anything beyond that.
The gold medals to the Olympic champions representing the United States of America.
1984, you attempted to make the Olympic team and were cut. And afterwards, Charles Barkley was cut. And you guys got into a car. What happened on that car ride?
Well, there were 4 or 5 guys cut at the same time. So we all rode to the airport, a long ride to the airport together. And mostly we listened to Charles. I was disappointed that I was cut. I missed my graduation the day I was cut. And that was important to me. But no, I've never looked back and felt like I wanted to show anybody. They said when we were cut, hey, if it had been another coach, maybe you'd have made it.
Jazz has conceded defeat.
Did you ever feel, particularly maybe at some point this season, that that window may have closed after the repeated chances of getting to the championship? Did you feel it was narrowing because of age?
No, not really. I think that our old guys take very good care of themselves. Our young guys are getting better, not only better from last year, but better as the season has progressed. So I wouldn't limit this team by ever thinking that window was narrowing and closing.
John Stockton, to me, as a person, is unbelievable. And as a player, MVP award wouldn't be complete if he wouldn't have been there on our team this year. And our first year run deeper than basketball.
Without Carl, none of us would have been close to that. He led us. He did all the big things. He was tremendous all season long, and he deserved it. But we get a piece of it, all of us.
Russell will inbound at half court.
You see why John Stockton is one of the five best players I ever played against.
Stockton, open three.
This kid is one of the greatest players to ever play in this game. He's a big play player.
Get it! John Stockton sends the Utah Jazz to the NBA Finals.
I guess I don't want to take myself back to those moments and take away from the focus that's ahead of us. I have to prepare myself and help prepare this team to make our best run at the ultimate objective, and that's to win the championship.
John Stockton scored 15 points in the fourth quarter of that series-clinching win against Houston to lead the Jazz back from the deficit. And, Peter, some people might be surprised that it was John Stockton who took over the game at that point.
I think, Hannah, people were stunned that he took over because he's not supposed to have a scorer's mentality, although he's leading the Jazz in shooting percentage in the playoffs. Usually teams play him for the pass and not the shot. And I've got an interesting insight into that that he gave me during the All-Star game this past year. I asked him to sign my top 50 book for my 9-year-old son, and he did it. And I asked him to write something on it. He said, I don't do stuff like that. I said, well, why don't you write something about being unselfish? He said, I can't do that. He said, because sometimes you have to be selfish for the good of the team.
Now, Ron Harper is the tallest player who's guarded him in these playoffs, and he appears to be having some problems with Harper early. By our calculations, all five of Stockton's assists in the first half have come when Harper has not been guarding him. His three turnovers have come when Harper has been guarding him. And when we return, we'll talk more about the first half between the Jazz and the Bulls. But first, a message from Prudential and a word from the NBA.
Been in there for 44 years, so there are a lot of memories. I was quite willing to try it, something new. We attracted people that were down in the lower range, but we also attracted people that were up in the higher range. The value range achieved the goal of giving us more money for our house than we had anticipated. What more can you ask?
No one taught me more about teamwork than my dad. They called him Mr. Mean because he never smiled. He didn't smile when he volunteered to coach the kids in the neighborhood. He didn't smile when he drove the team to every game or when he worked with kids for hours on his own time. He showed me anyone can make a difference if they just get involved. I'll tell you something else about my dad. He's got a great smile.
Team up with your community.
Yeah.
It's halftime in Chicago. In game one. Now let's talk about the first half, a half which saw both coaches go five deep in their benches. Doc, can you compare the efforts by the non-starters in the first half?
I'll tell you, the reserves are clearly going to play major roles, not only in this half, but throughout this series. Tony Kukoc is getting some extra minutes here because of a slow Scottie Pippen. He's hit a couple of three-pointers. He's played pretty good defense, but the Jazz bench has more than answered. Greg Foster has been great. Howard Eisley's hit some shots. And then if you take Carr, you take Morris, you take the other guys on their bench, you know, for Utah Jazz basketball watchers, this has been the best bench in the league, superior to the Chicago Bulls bench, and they might make the difference in this whole series.
Meanwhile, Karl Malone struggling, missed some easy shots really early on, 5-for-14 shooting, Mike, but is he doing some other things to help his team have the lead at the half?
I know Peter mentioned that Stockton basically throughout the playoffs has been their leader, leading field goal percentage guy. But when you look at the Jazz, everything comes through Karl Malone. He has taken twice as many field goal attempts as the second closest guy, Hornacek, twice as many free throw attempts as the second closest man, which is Hornacek. But let's look at some of the other ways that he helps his teammates during the course of the game. So many times the ball starts in the post. There he hits Stockton on the opening play, back cut for a layup. Again, ball in the post, reads the defensive team, looks opposite and finds Hornacek underneath for an easy score. And then when you're struggling from the floor as he is, shooting only 5 for 14. You have to find other ways of coming up. Defensive rebound, he's the guy that got the ball, but pay attention. The mailman runs the center of the floor, right back to him in transition for one of those 5 field goals that he has. Great players find a way to help their team.
And we should mention Scottie Pippen, a lot of speculation on how he would play with a left foot injury. He's played 20 minutes, 3 of 6 from the floor for 8 points. It's halftime in Chicago. The Jazz lead the Bulls by 4. We'll send it back to courtside for the second half right after these messages from your local station.
This has been the Prudential Halftime Report, brought to you by Prudential, bringing strength and stability to America's families through insurance, healthcare, real estate, and financial services.
Hey, if you haven't been watching Mad About You every Tuesday, then this week, it's new to you.
You give a man a fish, he eats for a day. If you teach a man to fish, he eats for a lifetime.
You know, don't you, that that's a side of you nobody likes?
Hey, did you see this, Frasier, where the Crane Boys have a double date? Ooh la la.
Can we just give us one clear signal?
Well, I'm off to bed. Niles, are you coming?
Hello. And what about this Caroline?
How's the mural coming?
Fine.
Check it out, because if you haven't seen it, it's new to you, NBC Tuesday.
Got an itch to be rich? Get to Texaco.
Get a free Race to Millions game piece.
Scratch the card and you could win $1 million if one of the 11 Texaco drivers wins a race.
Millions in cash and prizes. One in four could be a winner.
If they win, you could win $1 million.
That's a lot of pressure.
That's a lot of money.
In some places, full-time four-wheel drive isn't a luxury. It's a necessity. The incredible 7-passenger Lexus LX 450. Take the high road at Superior Lexus.
Only one airline offers Kansas City the best care in the air. Midwest Express. With new expanded service, Midwest Express has nonstop service to New York, LaGuardia, and Omaha. Plus, Kansas City's only nonstops to Boston and Milwaukee. On board, you'll experience our award-winning service with the widest coach seats in America and delicious cuisine, all for competitive coach or discounted fares. Call your travel professional or Midwest Express today.
Dry weather to start our June. All the details tonight at 10.
Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Third Rock from the Sun.
We will Third Rock you.
What you talking about, Willie?
Tommy's upset because he has to wear bows. The hacker man is sucking on Mary's toes. Sally's in love with that Seinfeld guy. Harry's got a headache and he doesn't know why.
We will Third Rock you.
You are a super freak.
The kind you don't take home to mother.
We will Third Rock you.
Sundays.
Welcome back to Chicago. Utah with a 42-38 lead on the Bulls. As we head to the second half, Marv Albert, Bill Walton, Matt Gukas. Matt, the playoff problems continue for the Chicago Bulls.
Well, they're staying almost exclusively with their triangle offense and settling for jump shots or post-up jump shots for Michael Jordan. The Bulls have only been to the foul line 6 times against a team like Utah that gives 30 foul shots a game. Chicago's got to come out and spread the offense.
Now, Bill, Utah not shooting well, but Jerry Sloan certainly has to be satisfied with many phases of his game.
Marv, it's their type of tempo. The Jazz in complete control, passing, the rebounding. The big thing for Utah, don't get overconfident. This thing is just getting started here.
Let's take a look at some of the Miller Lite halftime statistics. Looking at the Utah Jazz overall, just under 44% shooting, 16 of 36 from two-point range, only 5 three-point attempts, and just 4 of 5 at the line. Carmelo, 20 minutes, 5 of 14 overall. You see the breakdown in terms of defending against Malone.
It's great, though, that Karl Malone is getting a lot of shots. An MVP-type player like Karl needs 25, 30 shots per game. Everything going well for him except the touch.
And for the Chicago Bulls, only 40% from the field, 14 of 33 from two-point range, 2 of 7 from downtown. And they, too, did not go to the line. 4 of 6 at the line. Jordan, 21 minutes, 6 of 14 overall.
And Utah has not had to double-team Michael Jordan because he's settling for that fadeaway jump shot as soon as he starts to make a move into the lane. Then he'll draw the defense.
So it is Utah with a 42-38 lead on Chicago. Back with the second half in a moment.
Finally, you can drive what you've always dreamed about, the Aurora V8. If this engine can power the Indy race cars, imagine how you'll feel on a test drive. Isn't it time you drove your dream car? For a limited time, you can lease the Aurora for just $399 a month. See your Oldsmobile retailer. The Aurora V8, the power behind Indy.
This dish is going to change my life.
I like you better already.
Turn it on.
And now, I give you...
Game time.
Heidi.
They said it was on satellite TV.
It's on DirecTV. DirecTV?
You don't have DirecTV.
You got Heidi.
Only DirecTV delivers more sports than any other mini dish system. If you don't have it, you're going to get it.
If you squint, she kind of looks like John Elway.
DirecTV. Satellite TV at its best.
Grant, it's time to look beyond basketball. I'm thinking made for TV drama.
You want me to be just like Tommy, Dad, but I can only be Jake.
After that, you go on tour with your book. Then you cut an album.
I'm a cowboy.
So, what do we think?
I'd never do something like that. Care for a spray?
Think you've seen every single must-see Thursday show? Oh, you probably missed something.
Nah.
Like when Chandler fooled around with one of Joey's sisters. Then there's a special Thursday news radio. And Seinfeld's famous Cadillac episode.
Yeah.
And on Suddenly Susan, see how it all began. Hey, if you haven't seen it, then it's new to you, NBC Thursday.
Ahmad Rashad back in Chicago. Phil Jackson told his team at halftime that they've got to get more second shots. He also told them they got to really take care of the ball because what's happening on their turnovers is Utah's getting a lot of easy, uncontested shots off the turnovers. Another thing that he told them, he wants them to start running the ball, get out, get them some easy shots on fast breaks. Let's go down to Jim Gray.
All right, thanks, Ahmad. Well, it was very confident, upbeat Utah locker room. Jerry Sloan told his team he was very happy with the pace and tempo of the game, wants to see much of the same in the second half. Defensively, he told them, hey, guys, you must not allow them any more offensive rebounds to get second chances. And on offense, he said, set and hold the picks, get better shots. Karl Malone finally said, I still like our chances. Marv?
All right, thanks, guys. Third quarter underway. 4-point Jazz lead. Utah ball as we get going. Horner second. Stocked into the backcourt. Malone up front with Ostertag and Russell off the steal. Jordan stopped in the open floor and then run into by Russell.
How many times did Michael Jordan turn Brian Russell around that time?
Well, Karl Malone early in this game finding cutters because he couldn't find his shot. Here, Eiseley finds Karl Malone running on the fast break, and Dennis Rodman has had problems with Malone's little fadeaway jump shot.
Luke Longley set up by Michael Jordan. Dennis Rodman more and more a factor off the offensive board.
Disturbing situation in the first possession here. Give up an offensive rebound.
Pippen.
Two offensive rebounds. You have to establish yourself if you're going to have any chance to beat Chicago. One shot every time.
Utah Jazz went 64-18 during the regular season. That's a franchise record. Dangerous pass. And it backfired. Couple of bad possessions by the Jazz. Here's Jordan. Could not take advantage.
Well, Utah had 8 turnovers, uncharacteristic for them in the first half. And then to start the third quarter, 2 terrible passes.
Well, the passes are there, but the guards for Chicago, including Scottie Pippen, they have very, very long arms. Great anticipation.
Another turnover. Stockton threw it away, but the Bulls gave it right back. Ostertag could not handle that pass from Stockton.
Sloppy start for Utah. And they haven't lost any ground.
Well, for a team that's capable of shooting 50% or better, Utah, you would think they would just make sure they come down a good shot. But a very fast start here in this third quarter from Jazz.
And the crowd trying to get the Bulls going. A bad pass from Rodman. Poor spacing on this break. They run through and create the Hornacek. Hopper able to collar it. The Chicago Bulls, 69-13 during the regular season, did not have many top flight moments in the playoffs through the series against Washington, then Atlanta, then Miami. And Hopper's pass deflected away. And following the fake was put Stockton on the floor.
Stockton is a tough, hard-nosed defender who will stand in against anyone, no matter how big they are. Everybody's getting their hands on passes here.
Oh, Scottie Pippen with a good-looking three-point shot. He drilled it, and Pippen is showing some signs despite the foot injury. 4 of 8 from the field. He has 11 points. Holding foul, says the outside Fisher. Official Ed Rush, it's on Rod Hopper.
Well, the Chicago Bulls, during the regular season, scoring that 103 points a ball game, but it has been going down, down, down. Now, that's a lot of that has to do with playoff basketball, a lot of half-court play, very little transition, but this is ridiculous.
Jeff Hornacek. So the Jazz leading now 44-41. Hornacek playing Jordan. Along with the rebound. That's 8 rebounds for Karl Malone.
Get Karl on the run. Rodman didn't get back.
And Pippen had an ocean to run. Utah did get back. Pippen for three.
Wild shot.
And in many cases, John Stockton would have flipped that ball ahead to Brian Russell, but the way that the Jazz have been turning it over, he wants to make sure.
Russell. Nice lead pass for Russell. His second field goal, he has 7 points, and the Jazz lead by 5.
Mark, never underestimate the athleticism of this Utah team, particularly Brian Russell and Shandon Anderson.
Let it go! Let it go!
That shot goes down for Luke Longley. You can pull him in this championship.
Hill, he actually made a couple of those in the Miami series. Look at this third quarter. More turnovers than points.
Jordan screening for Rodman. That's what it's come to.
Well, Dennis Rodman looking for the offense. In fact, was a post-up go-to player the last couple of games against the Miami Heat. That's his second field goal here tonight. The Jazz 46, the Bulls 43. Oh, the block. Pippen, uncontested. The champ of defense. Malone comes out to set the screen. The lead for Malone off the pick and roll.
Well, Utah expects Chicago to send that pick and roll towards the baseline. And Jerry Sloan telling me yesterday, John Stockton actually likes that. He knows where everybody is, and he showed right there why he likes it so much.
Pippen lost the handle. Scottie Pippen looking very active here in this third quarter. Overall, 13.7 rebounds and 3 block shots. 13 on the 24. Chicago maintaining possession. Hopper and Jordan at the guards. Pippen, Rodman, and Longley up front. Pippen putting moves on Russell. And hit it.
Scottie Pippen, one of the greatest players of all time, schooling Brian Russell, an up-and-coming star. Brian has to play better, though. He was 1-for-12 in the regular season loss here, Utah at Chicago.
The Jazz by 1. Hornacek squeezing his way through. Ostertag with the rebound and the tip.
To be over 7 feet tall, what a dream.
Something that Matt and I cannot relate to, Bill.
I never quite made it, Marvin. A paltry 6'11".
Post attack at 7 foot two, about 280 pounds. Rothman, air ball.
The Bulls have resorted to setting double screens for Dennis Rodman.
And the Utah jumpers. And the Utah Jazz aren't going to guard him if he's going to keep shooting that way.
Utah by three as we come up on 6 minutes remaining in this third quarter. Stockton.
Beautiful play at Stockton. They're still figuring out how Chicago is going to play the pick and roll.
Scottie Pippen with seven of the Bulls, 9 points in this third quarter. Malone comes out aggressively on Pippen. Phil Jackson wanted a foul called. Hoffer waving it off. Now Jordan posting up Hornacek. Going glass. The Jazz 50, the Bulls 49.
By and large, Utah has denied penetration. Scotty everywhere trying to provide the spark.
Shot clock at seven. Hornacek. Jeff Hornacek getting the roll. That's his third field goal. He has six, and it's the Jazz by three.
And the reason why Chicago wants to send it down, force it down, the one time they sent Stockton actually behind the backboard made that a tough shot. But it's very difficult to find options when you force that dribbler down.
Michael Jordan hacked on the play. He's headed to the line, and a timeout is taken. Scottie Pippen has been a major factor here in the third quarter.
Good to see him exerting himself, first with the block and then the easy breakaway. Taking care of that foot, not extending himself, and then in the post, just taking advantage of the younger but very, very talented Brian Russell. Scottie Pippen, nice little hook step to the baseline, jump hook face.
5:05 remaining in the third. It's the Jazz by three.
The NBA Finals continue. Game two, Wednesday at 9 Eastern, 6 Pacific on NBC.
They said imports taste better. They lied.
And how does that make you feel?
Used, manipulated, betrayed.
And how does that make you feel?
Used, manipulated, betrayed.
So now what?
I'll only drink fresh beer. Budweiser.
You have made a real breakthrough.
You did it on your own.
We're not dating from Budweiser. What fresh beer tastes like.
You're on the road to freshness. Hold all my calls.
Nobody's tougher on motor oil than a police force. The extreme stress and searing heat generated by their hard driving can break down an oil in no time. That's why the Kansas City Police use Castrol GTX, the only leading 10W30 that provides maximum protection against both viscosity and thermal breakdown. Because some people have more important things to worry about. Castrol GTX. Drive hard.
Also try Castrol Syntec Blend for added synthetic protection.
Ah, these sport utes. They're a different breed for you, huh? Not for the timid, these things.
No, sir.
Got that whole other kind of suspension thing going on. Now, if you ask me, the whole thing's a little over-calibrated. I mean, of course, on a smooth road like this, you're not going to notice. But you get your potholes, your various road anomalies.
Believe you me, you're going to feel it.
Feel what? You're in a Bravada with ride and handling you wouldn't expect in an SUV. So the only thing you'll feel is really comfortable. Bravada. It knows the road.
Did we just go over some train tracks?
The NBA on NBC is brought to you by Brewery Fresh Budweiser, who reminds you fresh beer tastes better. By Oldsmobile and your local Oldsmobile retailers. And by Reebok, helping athletes perform at the top of their game.
Welcome back to Chicago. On that last play, Karl Malone of the Utah Jazz reopened the wound on his right hand that he suffered a floor burn in the last series against Houston. Now, during the timeout, that wound was attended to by Mike Szyminski, the trainer of the Utah Jazz. He's struggling with it. He put another patch on it. What he really can't do, though, is cover it during the game because it takes all feel away from him. So he wants it to get hardened again, but the problem is the sweat keeps getting on it. Now there's blood and sweat. Controlled during the timeout, he should continue. Marv?
All right, thanks, Jim.
Marv, it's a big, open, ugly, nasty sore. It just oozes all the time. And not really something that is fun to deal with and will not close up, really, until he stops playing basketball for quite a long period of time.
Michael Jordan
at the line for the first time. Scottie Pippen has really lifted his play here in the third quarter despite the foot injury. For more of that, let's check in with Ahmad.
All right, thanks, Marv. You know, the injury is more that Scottie is adjusting to it. It hasn't gotten any better. He's still painful. At halftime, he took his shoe off, readjusted his foot a little bit, but the pain is still there. It's just the fact that he's dealing with it a lot better. Marv?
All right, thanks, Ahmad. Jazz by two, just under 5 minutes remaining in this third quarter. Howard Eisley, who just returned, played well in the first half. Came up short. There's Pippen with the steal.
Well, Phil Jackson has gone to a lineup right now. John Stockton's out of the game, but you got Pippen, Jordan, Kukoc as your wing players, Longley and Robin in front. This could give John Stockton a lot of trouble down the stretch.
Jordan and Hornacek reaching for that rebound.
I think Phil Jackson might want to go smaller, get Longley out of there as Jordan gets called for the reach-in foul. You go smaller because Utah's controlling the boards, playing with more quickness. The power game for Chicago, not effective right now.
Right, Bill, right now he has Longley with Rodman and Kukoc, Jordan, and Pippen, and the matchup is Jordan defending on Hornacek. Stockton is getting a rest. Eisley is on the floor, being played here by Kukoc. Oh, wild pass.
Greg Ostertag is he's upset with his teammate right now. I think it's Brian Russell I don't think he threw the pass. It was Eisley who whipped it in there, but Greg Ostertag has to keep his hands up. He's going to break his nose.
I like that pass. Throw it in there nice and hard right at the head. Hit him in the head the next time. He'll catch it, I guarantee it.
Utah with 14 turnovers, 6 in this third quarter. Along with the pucks out and a high elbow that was avoided by Pippen.
He was pushed first by Rodney.
Oh, that makes it all right.
He was pushed into Scotty.
Eisley to the crossover. Setting it up for Ostertag, and it's a travel. Greg Ostertag.